Hello, Hans-Josef Fell. You are president of the Energy Watch Group, and 15 years you were a member of the German Parliament. And you are co-author of the famous German feed-in tariff, which was then exported to more than 100 countries worldwide. Recently, you hit the news by saying that feed-in tariffs are the much better policy than tenders. Why is that?
When you look to Germany, we have a great success with renewable expanding in the last decade, and it is mostly driven by many, many decentralized actors, private people, cooperatives, farmers, small and medium companies, and others. They were stimulated by a feed-in tariff. Now we have the change to a tender system, and the tendering is so difficult for the small and medium actors that they cannot take part. So we switch out a great movement of democratizing the renewable energies, the energy system to democracy. And this is not a good idea. We can and we should use tenders for big and large investment, over 40 megawatt perhaps. But above this line, under 40 megawatt, we should use feed-in tariff mostly on a modern system. I propose a feed-in.
What is a modern system?
We should look to make more investment in integrated renewable energy systems so that an investor can serve the electricity demand by 100% renewables, a mix of solar and wind, hydro, geothermal, bioenergy, a mix of storage, different things. Let him free to do it. Give him a remuneration, a feed-in tariff that is high enough that his investment into 100% renewables with covering the hourly, yearly demand all over the year, that he can make such an investment.
Your topic, you are the closing speaker of this conference here, and your topic is the path towards 100% renewables. What are your three action fields or recommendations that urgently need to be done to reach this field, this target?
Yeah, we need a good political framework. This means feed-in tariff for all the small and medium investment. And we need feed-in tariff all over the world in a modern size. We need, but also capacity building, know-how transfer, exchange with a technology acknowledge, but also with a social acknowledge, with a cultural acknowledge that renewables are the most decisive path to climate protection. And then when we have it, then the world can run on this pathway very, very fast. We will publish a new study next week in Bonn at the UN Climate Conference, and we can show that renewable energies are able to cover all over the year in an hourly resolution 100% renewables, and this 100% renewable electricity system is even the cheapest energy system what we have on the world.
I hope you make sure as well at COP that electricity is only 20% of the final energy use on this globe, and 80% is heat. So how about our transport, heat and transport to be exact. So what is your ideas towards the decarbonizing the heating segment then?
Yeah, this study is the first study only for the electricity sector, but we work already on a global energy system by the whole. And you are completely right, we must look to all the energy sectors, electricity, transport sector, heating and cooling sector, industry sector, desalination sector to bring sweet water to the people. And we need in such a switch to 100% renewables, all technologies what we can achieve. And solar thermal are very important technologies, including in this game of 100% renewables. We need them for electricity, CSP. We need it for desalination. We need it for industry sector and chemical processes. Heating, solar heating can help a lot in cooling sector and heating sector. We can make district heating and much more. Solar heating is an important pillar on the pathway to 100% renewables.
So I hope you have a good forum for your messages at the COP23 next week in Bonn.
Thank you very much.